It's the 13th of the 7th, 2011. This is today's climate change updates. I'm going to start with the energy news. And I'm just reading the headline, folks. There's definitely stories you need to pay attention to. We got a report, peaches in Los Angeles area found with radiation at more than double site background levels. Los Alamos lab begins removing radioactive soil from canyons to prevent contamination from spreading after fire. And if you remember, they're closing the trails out there to the public. Shock? Question mark. Cow meat with high levels of radiation now circulating all over Japan. Cattle had previously only been screened for radioactivities on the skin. As it kind of reminds you of the Gulf oil smell test that they're doing to the seafood in the Gulf of Mexico. I don't eat seafood at all. Radioactive ash, 70,000 plus BQs found near Tokyo, collected in late June and early July. Again, they can't keep the facts from leaking out of Japan. This thing is beyond out of control and insane. Local TV, feds accused of failing to keep public informed of radiation from Fukushima. And high levels of radiation detected in the U.S. Northwest rainwater. Fire nuclear testing area 65 miles northwest of Las Vegas. And the feds are checking for radiation. I wonder if we'll get the report on that. Radiation data from Seattle area survey may be withheld by feds for national security purposes. And expert appears that more nuclear fuel damaged at Fukushima than all other reactor accidents in history combined. And the Army Corps of Engineers warns of forecasting calling up for three more inches of rain in the Missouri River Basin. Record dam release continue as reservoirs so close to cresting. And they're letting these dams go as fast as they dare. And still we get more and more rain here in the north central United States and southern Canada central. The flooding continues. Cows were fed hay with radioactive cesium at 250 times the legal limit, a 75,000 becquerels per kilogram in Japan. So it's a wonder that these cows were radioactive meat when they're feeding them radioactive hay. Over to EarthChanges, Scott.net tonight. United States storm causes power loss for 868,000 people in the Chicago area. Service has been restored to 500,000. And there's some really good videos out there of the storm damage in the Chicago, greater Chicago area. Feels like 120 temperature settings stuck on broil across the United States. And we are getting a little break here in Des Moines, but it doesn't come without much unneeded rain. I would love to send it down to you in Texas, but it's insane. Prelude to Ice Age. Volcanoes cause more rain than previously realized. Volcanoes may release particles that can cause changes in local and regional weather at rates of up to 100 million times higher than previously realized. The eruption last spring of Iceland's Eyjafjallajökull volcano provided French scientists with perfect natural laboratory to measure levels of weather-changing particles released in such eruptions. Taking measurements at a research station in central France, they found that the eruption released much larger amounts of particles at low levels in the atmosphere than previously known. So volcanoes are definitely climate changers, no kidding, right? The harbingers of change can now be seen all around the world. Mysterious Noctilucent clouds brighten up the skies in the north. And again, I've been reporting on these night shining clouds on the northern hemisphere, and they just keep heading more and more south, and these are caused by energy in the magnetosphere. And there's some pretty crazy things going on right now. They say it's normal in the spring and summer, but this year it's kind of record-breaking yet again. The United States, Russell Springs, Kansas. Unusually harsh weather conditions cause an exceptionally rare hibernation period in prairie dogs. So apparently these prairie dogs were in hibernation longer than normal, and they had their pups late, and they had fewer pups, and now they're saying that's okay. Harvested said the first prairie dog pups of the year were spotted on May 25th, perhaps as many as 20 days later than normal. Even then, the number of young in a litter appeared to be fewer than normal. So, on with the climate change, that the animals do adjust to that, and that's just part of, there's definitely something going on that's record-breaking. Richmond County, North Carolina, lightning kills 20 cows, more extreme weather. U.S. record temperatures seen as heat wave plagues 23 states, and over 100 degree heat index, just insane hot. Here comes the sinkholes. Lenoir, North Carolina, sinkhole evidence of a possible wider problem. And Scotland, homes and cars flooded in Edinburgh, downpour. So Scotland's still having severe weather. Massive sinkhole opens in DeSeta, Texas, and they've got some pretty crazy video coming out with that, like tractors falling into this thing. It's just huge. More sinkholes. Over to the Extinction Protocol. Triple string of moderate earthquakes near volcano at Rock, Costa Rica. A triple string of moderate 5.0 earthquakes have struck the region of Costa Rica. The earthquakes range from magnitude 5.1 to 5.6 and are a clear indication of tectonic plates are being jolted by a growing seismic tension. The shallowest quake in the swarm was struck about 42 kilometers from Libera, was 30 kilometers deep, and there have been no reports of damage. The earthquakes occurred near the region of the Rincon de la Vija volcano, which is active, but last erupted in 1998, and yet more volcanic activity. Pronounced magma bulge seen at Hawaii's Kilauea volcano. The bulging Pauau crater on the east rift of the Hawaii's Kilauea volcano is putting on a show, and there's no telling what could be next. A USGS Hawaiian Volcanic Observatory video recorded at the site shows a time-lapse sequence taken from a thermal camera on the rift. The movie spans from May 26 to today and shows the rising level of lava in the lake and the crater. Things to be appear to be going slow at the first part of the movie, which shows the eruption during the month of June. And of course, that's just more and more activity out of the volcano in Hawaii. A massive June explosion on the sun continues to mystify NASA scientists. Now, this event took place on June 7th, 2011. There's an eruption on the sun, and this dark matter came out of the sun, and then you can see it splash back on, and even spaceweather.com's got it posted up there, so sun's doing some pretty weird things. Giant dust storm enshrouds Algeria and Mali. Desertification worsening under climate change. And again, this is kind of a global warming thing, but there are huge dust storms forming in the deserts in Africa. And again, the droughts and famines continue. It's just extreme drought and flood in the south. 2011 on target for most earthquakes recorded in 12 years. Explosions and ashfall increase at the Ombe volcano in Vanuatu, and they've been having a lot of earthquake activity, and that is the volcanic activity going off down in the Vanuatu area. And they've got a bunch of underwater volcanoes there too. Flooding from torrential rains kills 10 in Nigeria. And here's an interesting one. Scientists discover a new large underwater volcano chain near Antarctica. Science from a British Antarctic survey have discovered previously unknown volcanoes in the ocean waters around the remote South Sandwich Islands. Using shipborne seafloor mapping technology during research cruises aboard the RRS James Clark Ross, the scientists found 12 volcanoes beneath the sea surface, some as high as 3 kilometers high. I find it hard to believe, with everybody's navies and submarines, that they just discovered these volcanoes. Might that be the reason that the ice is melting so quickly? We have volcanoes under Antarctica. We have volcanoes under the Arctic, if you bother to check. So, volcanoes in the oceans changing the pH level and all the madness that's going on with that. 6.4 magnitude earthquake rattles the Philippine province of Negros, and that's again a volcanic area. And over to the RSOE, and this one's about the Katla Iceland volcano. Scientists went on expeditions to the site of the glacial flooding by the glacier in South Iceland last week to learn about the circumstances taking place of the gas water to determine whether the subglacial volcano Katla erupted. Let's get on to the meat of it. Only a part of the area is still defined as a danger zone. The flood originated in 3 known calderas, not 2 as reported earlier. And a new caldera has been formed in the glacier that is over Katla. So Katla's definitely gearing up. And back to the RSOE. There's some other things on here that are real quick. Extreme weather's reports coming out of Sweden. Forest fire in Spring Mountain, Nevada. Heat wave in Indiana, southern Indiana, well, pretty much all over the southeast United States. Flash flooding in Alberta, Canada. Heat wave in the southern region of Italy. Snowstorms in the highlands of Potsi in Bolivia. And a heat wave in Bulgaria, the southwestern and northern area. Forest fires out of the Northwest Territories in Canada. And that's about everything new today, 12 and a half minutes. Please leave your comments or post your videos below. Enjoy what you can, everybody. Thanks.